Hello everybody, my name is Costa. I'm your Technical Competence Manager from the Yaskawa Channel Partner TMC team. Today I'm going to be talking about the Mechatron Link 3 coupler and how we configure it in the software. Before I start with the configuration, I will briefly explain a few things about the Mechatron Link 3 coupler with the article number 05-31ML00. Here are the topics. First of all, the properties, the structure, the LEDs, interface, address switch, configuration page, and at least a live configuration with the Movicon Works ESC Pro version and the CPU, the MP3300. We start with the properties. Field bus. The Mechatron Link 3, according to IEC 61158 and IEC 61784. The Mechatron Link 3 coupler for maximum 64 peripheral modules that support standard I/O profile, 16-byte and 64-byte mode, multiple slave node with maximum 9 station. The coupler itself, the address extension is 0 hex and the periphery modules from 1 hex. Maximum 492-byte input and 492-byte output data. The coupler needs a 12-byte input and 12-byte output data, and the peripheral modules 480-byte input and 480-byte output data. They have an integrated TC 24-volt power supply for power and electric section supply of the periphery modules, have an integrated web server, and a configuration is done via software tool, respectively web server. Here the structure, the second topic from this Mechatron Link coupler. How you see here, we have the interface itself and is an integrated power module inside from this coupler. You see here also. Next topic, the LEDs. Here I show you the LEDs from the power module and also from the bus interfaces. And here a description about that. Here you see also if you get an error, LED constellation, what they mean with a description here on the side. The interface. Mechatron Link 3 connection via two RJ45 jacks, that means two ports, by means of a Mechatron Link cable. You see here now the Mechatron Link cable with the article number where you can order. You see from one side here the Mechatron Link side and here also a normal Ethernet RJ45. What you need to use it. You see also here I have built up. How you can build up a topology. You see here, you can build up a cascade topology and also possible a star topology. You see here. Next one, the address switch. The address switch serves for the following settings. The first one is the selection of the operating mode. The second one, the adaptation of the Mechatron Link 3 address. You see here the switch on this interface, Mechatron Link, And also here a description about the switches. Please be careful and please note, if you configure the maintenance switch, the first one, an address may only be assigned once in the Mechatrolling 3 network. Change of the address switch were only recognized after power on or a reset. The address set on the address switch must always be identical to the device address in your configuration tool. The configuration of the Mechatrolling 3 coupler. You have two ways. The first one is via the web page. If you configure on the switch the maintenance mode, the first switch to one, you can configure it via the web page. The second way is to configure it with the MotionWorks IEC software. And you see here, you add a Mechatrolling coupler, and you have here your coupler and also some IOs. Here also an example what you can configure. So now we are finished with a briefly explanation. Now let's get started with a live configuration in the software. So before I start with the configuration in the software, we need to set the IP address to the Mechatrolling 3 coupler. That means we switch from 0 to 1, the label C, the first one, I use here a screwdriver, and I use here the label 8, that means I want to use the IP address 192.168.1.8, and my PC is in the same area with the 100 in the last position, and the CPU also in the same area, that means with the IP address in the last position 1. Okay, now we switch off the coupler for reboot and initialization, and we switch on the coupler. Okay, the next step is to build up the connection with the cable. Okay, I use here a LJ45 cable. Okay, and now I open a browser. It's up to you which one do you want to use. In my case, I use the Firefox, Mozilla Firefox, and put the IP address in the browser. .8 and enter. Okay, now we are online to our coupler, and you see here automatically they funded the modules. We have 4 modules, that's right. A digital input, a digital output, an analog input, and a counter module. You find here also the configuration management here, and now we configure the counter module. Okay, we can say here also pulse in direction, and we can use your counter endless, for instance, it's also possible. Okay, then I go back to our coupler configuration and I save the current device parameters what I have set now. All right, now we can close the browser and we go back to the operation mode. That means we switch back from 1 to 0, the first switch. And I reboot again the coupler. That means to switch off and switch on. Very nice. So, before I start with the software, I can build up the connection with the cable. Here it's important to use the special Mechatrol Link coupler to Ethernet. Here is it. And to build up the connection. Okay, first one. And okay, here from my PC, I connect directly to my CPU. Okay. We can start the MotionWorks ISC3 Pro version. Now you see here also in the middle from the software here, the work area. On the left side, the project tree or window. On the right side, the edit wizard with all FPs function and the libraries. And on the top here, you find also all buttons, for instance, a watch window or to go online that you can use. And on the bottom, you find here also all error message warnings and information. Okay. Now we create a new project. That means we go to File, New Project. Appears a window here and we use a MP3300 ISC. We remark it and confirm it with OK. You see automatically on our project on the left side, the libraries, the logical POI, and also the physical hardwares. Now we need to create a hardware container to build up this connection. Here you find the launch hardware configuration. We click on this button and automatically appears the hardware configuration container here. You see on the left side, we want to use a Mechatrol Link 3. That means we click on this, right mouse click, and to add a new device. Automatically here, open a window, and here we select our Mechatrol Link 3 coupler. Here, the IM053ML. We remark and confirm it with finished. We add the node number, this is 8, what we have here on the switch, configure. And we say add. On the left side, you see it's configured our Mechatrol Link coupler without the modules that we need to configure alone. That means my first digital input is 021, 1PF0. The second one is a digital output. 022 1PF 00. Then an analog input 031 1PD 30 and a counter module 050 1BA 00. You see also the hardware configuration are finished and we have the photorealistic here now exactly how is our application with the modules. So we save the project. On the top on the left side you have the save configuration button and we can now connect to our PLC. We find here on the right side on the top the connect button. We click on this. Automatically we try to build up a connection. Okay, here you see you want to use the offline configuration or use a startup configuration. We want to use our configuration, that means the offline configuration. We click on this and now we are online. You see here. we go back to our software. We close the window. So now we configure a little project in our software. We go to our project tree on the left side under logical POOs, under main, and double click on this main sheet, double click. Okay, and in our workspace in the middle are empty, and we use the end block. This is second one, per drag and drop, I bring it to our workspace, and we need to configure it with our digital input. And the name from our digital input you find under the global variables in our project tree on the left side. We double click on global variables and you see here our first digital input with a name. I remark, right mouse click, and we say here copy. Okay, and I can go back here to my main block. And I click here on this point with double click, appears a window, and here we can say right mouse click and say paste. Okay, the same with the second connection. We go to our global variables, double click, and we use now the second one. We mark right mouse click, copy, go back to our main block. We click on this point, and here we can say we remark right mouse click and to say paste, and we confirm it with OK. Okay, we have now two digital inputs, and if this digital, these two digital inputs are on, that means to one, then we need an output. And we have also a digital output module on our coupler. We go back to our global variables, double click, and we can close the digital inputs and open the digital outputs, and we can use the first one. We remark it, right mouse click, copy, and goes back to our main block, and here we can double click on this point. Appears a window, we remark it, right mouse click, and we can say paste and say okay. Okay, now we have write a little project. That means if the first digital input and the second digital input are on, then comes automatically the output. Okay, now we can say we save the project. We find on the top on the left side, and we can here under build to make all this project. This is to compile it. Okay, zero errors, zero warnings, very nice. Now we can transfer our hardware container and the software container what we have here configure. Under online project control, we find here so a control panel, and we can say here download all project. We click on this. Okay, now we are finished without errors, and now we can say start the project. Okay, and we automatically now online, and the CPU now in run. You see that first digital input, the second digital input are zero. I bring it to one. I have here two wires. I connect it. First one and the second one. Okay. Now I have connect the first two digital inputs, automatically comes the digital output. Okay, nice. You see also now here in the software, the values are true, two digital inputs, and automatically our digital output also true. So, we can count a module. That means we have a counter on this module 050, and we need to configure it. So we double-click on global variables, and you see here the 051PA is our counter module. We have set in the coupler before on direction and pulse and count endless. So that we can count, we need in the control byte to change from 0 to 4. More information you find about this counter module in the manual. And you need to open this software gate with the value 4 on our control word here. I click on this control word, right mouse click, and I open the debug dialog. And I put it here, the value 4, so that we can release and open this software gate from this module. And enforce it. You see automatically the value 4. Okay, now we have a set to pulse and direction. I have here prepared a wire that I give a pulse on my first counter module. And this is the label 1, pin 1. And how you see here this count, and also in our software, you see the pulse go up and they count it. And that also works. All right, now we are finished with this tutorial. Let me conclude what we have done. We have learned some key data from the Mechatrolling coupler. We have set an IP address in the maintenance mode to the Mechatrolling coupler. And at last, we have configured in the MotionWorks ISC Pro version the MP3300 ISC CPU and the Mechatrolling coupler 0531ML00. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Please feel free to contact me if you have any further information. Here my email address. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Until then, so long, and see you in the next tutorial. Bye.